Hello YouTube, welcome back to TechGeekers. It's me Rohit with another video, and in this video I'm going to show you guys how to improve your FPS in Fortnite or any other game. And for this video I'm using AMD graphics cards. This also works for Nvidia users, but you need to change settings according to Nvidia settings. So before we just jump into the video, I need to tell you guys one thing. This video is sponsored by Linkrex. So Linkrex is a online URL shortening service. They will pay for you for each clicks for your links. They also pay something around $15 for 1,000 views, which is good for a small YouTuber or blogger. Okay, let's jump into the video. So the first thing you need to make sure that you are on the latest version of AMD Radeon settings. So for that, right click and select AMD Radeon settings. So once that's open, you can go to updates tab, and there you can see what is your current installed version. If it's above 18.xx, then you are on the latest version. If you are below that, like 16. then you need to update your graphics card. I already put a video in YouTube about how to install, uninstall graphics card completely and install the latest version of AMD driver and AMD software. So you can check out this video, and this is the title of the video. I'll also put the link in the description. That is how to install, update, download AMD graphics card driver 2018. And once you are on the latest version, we can jump into the next step. So the next step is we need to make your game understand that we need to use AMD graphics card instead of Intel graphics card, because if you are not assigning the game to AMD graphics card, then it will try to run on Intel or any integrated graphics card, and that's the reason some people are facing the problem with that. So I also put a video on how to switch from AMD Intel graphics card to AMD. I will put the link in the description. So this is a video how to switch from Intel HD graphics card to AMD Radeon 2018, and you just watch this video and switch the graphics card from Intel to AMD. But before that, you need to make sure that you are on the latest version, that is 18.xx. So after you update it to 18.xx, then you can follow this video and set your game to assign your game to AMD graphics card. So next, you need to do some tweaks on AMD Radeon settings. For that, open AMD Radeon settings by clicking on the right mouse button and select AMD Radeon settings. Once that is open, you need to go to gaming tab. From there, you can select global settings. Once that tab is selected, you will come up with this. Here you need to click on reset button and select graphics settings. So here we are resetting the graphics settings. So if you are already messed up with anything here, don't worry, so it will get reset back to normal. So this is the store condition. We are going to do some changes here. First, you need to click on this anti-aliasing mode and select override application settings. So that will pop up a new option here, that is anti-aliasing level. Put that on 2x, as lowest, that is 2x is the lowest. But you need to remember one thing, that when we are doing this, we are also decreasing the game's quality. So if you want to decrease, if you don't want to decrease the quality, then I'll recommend you guys to change all the settings in the game itself instead of changing here. But for people having low-end PC, so this is the best option for you. Then you need to look for anisotropic filter mode. Click on that and enable it. There you will see a new option, that is anisotropic filter level. Select 2x from there. And once that is selected, you need to look for vertical refresh, which is VSync, and you need to click on that and select always off. Once that is off, you need to look for something called tessellation mode and select it. Here it is already set to AMD optimized. You need to select override application settings for best performance. This will absolutely decrease your quality, I'm pretty sure. So after that is selected, you will pop up with a maximum tessellation level. Select that and select 32x. Once that's it guys, so these are the tricks that we can do on AMD Radeon settings. Once that is finished, you can there is no option to save, it's already saved. So that's finished, you can close this and your settings get saved. The next thing that we are going to do is we are going to change some settings inside the game. You can change all the settings that we done in AMD software, can be done also inside the game, which also hugely improve your FPS. For each game, it's different, but it's constantly, if you understand that, you can do it simply. But I'm trying to optimize Fortnite, so it's in main menu. Always you will see in main menu is something like a settings or a display setting, something like that. Click on that, and first thing is window mode. So window resolution is the first thing, that is the main thing you need to look for. If you set the display resolution to a very high amount, then that is one which causing you your shuttering and lag. So reduce that to something around which is comfortable for you. So it's a trial and error method, so you just try with one resolution, and if that's not fitting for you, then you can go for another resolution. And then when your video selector, which one is comfortable for you, you can select that. And then the next part is quality. You can go for low. If you are facing a lot of shuttering and lag issues, then you can go for low. And if you are okay with something like that, at some point you are only facing problems like shuttering, then you can go for medium settings. And then you can change some other settings like advanced. There will be some option like advanced settings. In Fortnite, there is everything, all settings are given in the video section, so it's you're going to go for other options. So here I'm looking for, you can see view distance. This is a typically option for all games, so just reduce that to low so that it's only render nearby objects. You can't see far away objects like mountains, anything like that. Shadow, that you can turn to off, and aliasing you can turn off. Texture, while you're reducing the texture, that also cause affect your game. You can, there are visibly a huge change in the game if you're trying to reduce the texture. But if you don't want, if you're only considering about FPS, then you can absolutely reduce this texture quality to low. And then effects, you can go for low. And post processing, you can go for low. And then the next thing is vSync. You need to turn that vSync down, off. Even though if you are on the medium settings, I would recommend you to turn off this vSync. And motion blur, it's up to you. If you like motion blur, but like new games all come with this motion blur, this will give you a realistic look. But if you are having a lot of lag in the game, then I would recommend you guys to turn off this motion blur. But that doesn't cause any effect in your game. So I would recommend you to turn it on if you like it. If you don't like it, then turn it off and click on apply or anything like this, and click on OK and go back then. So your graphic settings get set. The next thing that you need to go do is you need to minimize this game, and then you need to right click on taskbar. There you can see a lot of options popped up, and you need to select task manager from that. Also, you can use hotkey, that is Alt Control Delete, and select Task Manager from there. Once you are in the Task Manager, you need to go to Details tab and you need to look for the game application. You will find a number of applications having the same icon. So, in case of Fortnite, you can see three of these files have same application for icon and name, almost something similar. For looking for the right game, you need to look for memory section. Here you can see this application, that Fortnite client Win64 shipping almost takes something around 70 lakhs, 94,504 KB. So that is the application game you need to change. After you select the proper game file, you need to click on it, right click on it, and select set priority, and select it to high. Don't go for real time, that's not going to improve your quality, not improve your FPS. Go for high, that is good. Better than all of this, go for high, and then close the task manager and go back to the game. That's it, guys. I hope I'm pretty sure that this will anyway improve your FPS. If you can run this game on your PC, then you can absolutely increase your FPS by following all these methods. And if you are still facing problems, then I will recommend you for looking for a patch called low-end spec patch, something like that. You can search on Google and you'll get that. You can use his patch. He's a YouTuber. You can go for and download his patch and use on Fortnite or any game. He also offering patches for all other games, new games, or most of the new games he also offering. So that's it, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also like this video.